Hello everyone, and welcome to today's Twitch stream and flight, where we are flying the leg two of the Canadian Express May 2017 monthly challenge. We're flying from St. John's, Newfoundland to Halifax, Nova Scotia with the Mobile Z-AQ400 on the VATSIM network with 58 passengers. Our cruise altitude today is 22,000 feet with an expected flight time of 1 hour 58 minutes. This is, as I indicated before, this is leg two of the Canadian Express May 2017 monthly challenge. Yesterday we flew leg one. Actually, I had to fly it twice simply because the first time landed a little bit hard, so I had to redo the flight again. However, the second leg was a little bit better, so therefore we're able to continue on to leg two. We've currently called catering services, so they're on their way to load up refreshments and all that. And in the meantime, we're going to go ahead and start getting set up for our flight. Current weather in St. John's actually is not that nice. The winds are calm. However, the visibility is about 4 statute miles with fog. Temperature is 3 degrees, dew points 1. Altimeter is 3045. We'll be departing off runway 02, which is a 5,000 foot runway, which is more than sufficient for the Dash 8. And on that note, we're going to go ahead and start getting set up for our flight. We've got external power connected, and basically turn on our windshield heat, Python heat, etc. So we're going to go ahead and start getting set up. Our cruise altitude is 22,000 feet. As there is no ATC online right now, we're going to go ahead and set our altitude to our cruise, which is 22,000 feet. Before doing that, we're just going to go and set our altimeter to 3045. Quite high, and we're gonna go ahead cruise. Feet. And our departure for today will be on the St. John's 5, so it's basically runway heading up to 5,000 feet. So we'll go ahead and set our heading to runway heading, which is 016. And we'll be flying with the FMC, so let's go ahead and put our nav source to FMS1. And we'll go ahead and arm our anti-skid. And catering's still at it. And we'll go ahead and set our trim there in a second. I just need to pull out my speed card. Okay, catering's done. We'll go ahead and turn on our radios. F12, there we go. So, of course, boarding. And go ahead and pull up the speed card because I'm gonna need that to calculate our takeoff speeds. Unfortunately, you won't actually see the speed cards as they're on a. I use a secondary PC for a lot of stuff, including weather generation, etc. So it won't appear. Okay, so today we're going to take off with the 5,000 foot runway. Let's go with flaps 10. So our gross weight is almost 61,000 pounds, so we're gonna do flaps 10, let's say. So V1 will be 120. V1 120, rotate will be 122. Set V2 to about 142. They're a little bit high, but no big deal. Especially the V2, but they'll do the job. Okay, and go ahead and set my speed. The climb, initial climb, I usually like to be around 160, and then I'll increase that as we go. Usually once I'm airborne, aircraft stabilized, I'll go up to about 200 on the climb. Okay, heading set. And go ahead and turn on our weather radar. And we'll set our squawk to 2200, which is a IFR squawk in North America when there's no ATC online, which is currently the case. So when you're not assigned a squawk code, 2200 is the trick. what's going on here with GSX. Well, let's just do it the easy way. Resets. There you go. Request boarding. Problem solved. Alright, so let's fire up our FMC. And go to fuel. Okay, today we're carrying 6,661 pounds of fuel. Our zero fuel weight is 54176. Which gives a gross weight of 60837, which is exactly what we calculated, so that's good news. And baggage, passengers are being loaded. So we'll go in and enter in our flight plan for today, which is relatively short. So not a lot of data entry to do. So St. John's. First waypoint is Lexax. Then we're going for an airway, which is Q846, which is number 4, which will bring us to Silro, which is number 2. From Silro, we're going to Cayley, C-A-Y-L-Y. And then Halifax, C-Y-H-Z. Close all our doors, and we may as well go up and start the APU. Put our beacons on. Alright, so we got our flight plan. So departure will be off runway 02. There is no, it's not showing any SID or anything, so that's fine. our arrival into Halifax will be runway 23. Via the Cabot 1. Transition is Kaylee. And it'll be a number 1 ILS. Just get rid of this no link. That's a go around, so we'll leave that as is. That looks good. Okay. So for present position to Lexac, that's good. So that's set up in the VNAV. Just going to go ahead and start our ACARS. And you can see the APU is running. Captain's gonna go grab himself a quick coffee. When I come back, we'll start our engines. We'll be ready to go. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and turn off our external power, switch over to APU. There we go, we're now on APU. Connect our GPU, ground power unit, disconnected. And start engine one. On the technical side of things for today, we are flying a Bombardier-8 Q400, which is by Majestic. It's the pilot version. St. John's and Halifax Scenery are both by SIM add-ons. Ground vehicles, etc., are FSX Dream Team, GSX Ground Services. Okay, there we go, engine one. Okay, both engines are running, so we'll disconnect our GPU. Recirculation clouds, air conditioning. And we're gonna go ahead and turn on our icing, because climbing through, it looks like there's some clouds, so there's potential for picking up some ice. Flaps 10. And as there's no ATC, we've gone ahead and we are transmitting our intentions to other aircraft that may be in the area on Unicom. We'll go ahead and set our very to go. TCAS is on. Taxi lights. Strobes on, taxi lights off, landing lights on, no warnings, looks like we're good to go. That beeping sound was because I was using, and I do this sometimes, instead of using the rudder, I use. Gear up, flaps up. Also wasn't in climb power, which could be part of the reason too. Okay, and we're airborne, crossing 3. So we're gonna turn left to direct Leipzig. Okay, and we have LNAV capture. And we're in climb mode. Okay, and as expected, we have ice detect. Okay, 10,000 feet, landing lights off. Yeah, she's a little bumpy. tends to be smoothing out a little bit now. We'll just keep our eyes on that ice detected. That should disappear shortly, and we do have our anti-icing on. Things have smoothed out, so I'll turn off our seatbelt signs. We just press the all button, it'll show us, it'll flip through the different screens, electrical, engines, etc. There we go, icing detected, warning just disappeared, so that's a good sign. Alright, we're crossing through 18,000 feet, so we'll go ahead and reset our altimeter to 9 or 9 or 2. And we're going to go ahead and adjust our nose trim, it's a little bit off. And we're now level at flight level 220, and the aircraft is slowly increasing speed to our cruise speed. We're currently grounding 300 knots. We've got a headwind on the starboard side of 21 knots. Top of descent is at approximately 1 hour 9 minutes, or 345 miles. 30 minutes into our flight. We're cruising at 22,000 feet. Our ground speed is 320 knots. We've got a headwind of 15 knots. Top of descent is in approximately 290 miles or about 52 minutes. flight deck. We're just an hour into our flight, currently cruising at 22,000 feet. Our ground speed is 320 knots. We've got a headwind on the port side of 25 knots. Top of descent is an approximately 140 nautical miles, or about 25 minutes. So shortly we'll be preparing our approach, descent and approach into Halifax. Okay, from the flight deck, we're about 20 minutes from our topper descent. We're going to start planning our approach into Halifax. We'll be taking the Cabot 1 arrival for runway 23. Current winds and our current weather in Halifax is really not that nice. Winds are 187 at 16 knots, that's magnetic. Visibility is 0.5 statute miles, it's overcast at 200 feet. Temperature is 14, dew point's 14, altimeter is 2987. So basically, we're not gonna, from what it looks like, we're not gonna see the runway till we're on the numbers. So we're definitely gonna plan for a missed approach on this. We might have to come around and do it a second time. We'll see. Alright, so we'll open up our radio here. ILS frequency is 109.9. And the course will be 233. And we're going to want to come in low and slow, so we're going to do a flaps 35 approach. Our estimated landing weight is 56,500 pounds, so VREF is going to be 116. We're going to go ahead and add 20 knots to that just to be on the safe side. I always like to come in a little bit faster, so 116, 20, 136 will be our VREF. Actually, we're just going to put it at 130 because there's not really icing conditions or anything, so but don't want to come in too fast, so 130 should do it. And Leros, we're going to want to be at 3,000 feet. Yeah, Leros at 3,000, so we're going to go ahead and modify this and put at 3,000. No, it won't let me, okay. Okay, so our top of descent is in 111 miles. Okay, our top of descent has shown up on our flight display. Just going to do a quick revision of the weather in Halifax. Winds are 187 magnetic at 18 knots. Visibility is actually increased now. It's 2.5 statute miles. It's overcast at 300 feet. Temperature 14. Dew point 14 with fog. And the altimeter is 2988. So we'll be flying the Cabot 1 arrival for ILS runway 23, and we'll also going to set ourselves up here in case we need to do a go around. And we're now 54 miles from our top of descent. As there's no ATC online, as always, we're announcing our intentions on Unicom 122.8 via text. And so we're going to put our descent right away to 3,000 feet, which is where we need to be when we cross Lee Ross. We're going to go ahead and select the alt select at this time, and when we're about 10 miles or so from top of descent, we'll go ahead and enable VNAV, and that should enable the aircraft to descend by itself using the VNAV path approach in the FMC. Not much. probably pay all this good money for add-on scenery there so that you get this. Nothing but soup. Okay, we're about 20 miles from top of descent. We're going to go ahead and slowly throttle back, and 10 miles out we'll enable VNAV. seatbelt signs. And there we go, we've enabled the VNAV mode, so the aircraft should descend on its own when it reaches TOD, top of descent. Okay, it looks like we got both up twice in our flight pants. We're going to go ahead and delete one of those. There we go, the VNAV path, so we've started our descent. And approaching 18,000 feet, we'll reset our altimeter to 29,088, which is the current altimeter in Halifax. So we're currently at 16,500 feet. Ground speed is 260 knots. We expect to be on the ground. We're about 45 miles from the airport. We expect to be on the ground in roughly 10 minutes. And we're about to cross the Vosob intersection on the Cabot 1 arrival. Just crossing 10,000 feet, landing lights on. can. We're getting a little bit of chop crossing through 6,000 feet. And flaps 5. We're going to switch to heading select this time. And switch our nav source to for the ILS. And set our course, which is 233. And we're approaching 3,000 feet. And we got localizer capture. Flaps 10. Gear down. Flaps 15. happened there. Let's just recover from this stall. There, put the gear up, and we're gonna come back around and try that again. Not sure what happened there. Alright, so we're going to descend, we'll swing around, and let's try this again.
Bank angle. Bank angle. Caution. Terrain. Caution. Terrain.
All right, attempt number two. Gear down. Okay, we got the localizer. Flaps 15. And flaps full. Okay, we're on the glide slope. And we're about 5 miles from the field, still looking for it. 3 miles from the field, still looking.
Minimums.
concludes this flight and this Twitch stream. Thanks for watching, everyone, and blue skies.